Loving God, we thank you. We thank you for each other, and we thank you that we can gather together on this day to worship you. And as we join together, would you bless us and lead us and speak to us as we worship you this morning. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. So, today we are thinking about extravagant generosity. There's two good words, aren't there? But we're basically thinking about how we give of ourselves completely to God and why we do that. So, my question of us this morning is, what have we been given recently that was, or what was the most generous thing that somebody has ever done for us? What's the most generous thing? Or what have we been given recently? What's that? Silence. Death is on.
My Auntie Molly gave me her car.
Did she? Oh. Did you get that? Her Auntie Molly gave her a car.
A long time ago.
It was very long time. Yesterday. Long time ago. Anybody else?
They told her to give me a car, but it didn't go.
Your brother gave you a car, but it didn't go.
Yeah,
that was very generous, I think. Anybody else? What's one of the most generous things? Or have you given anybody anything? No.
I think it's little unexpected things. I'm sure there's lots of things.
Little unexpected things.
Yeah.
Or big things.
Yeah, they are. Little unexpected things. They don't have to be a part, so. Little unexpected things.
But it's special because it actually was up until 5 years ago. This son hadn't spoken to me for 18 years. So,
well, that's amazing. We've
had a mark of 5 years.
Oh.
Oh, thank
God. Oh, my.
Yeah.
Anybody else? Little bits of generosity.
Has Jesus been quite generous?
Yeah, I think we might think about that in a little bit, about how generous Jesus is to us. So let's pray before we begin as we pray together. Let everything be said and done in the name of the Lord Jesus. Giving thanks to God through Jesus Christ. Let us bring our gifts to the Lord, that they may be used for his glory. May the Spirit of God fill our hearts as we come to meet him in this place. And so we're going to sing. We're going to sing, "Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King."
Thank you.
worship here this morning.
And he pitied them and healed their sick. That evening, the disciples came to him and said, It is already past time for supper, and there is nothing to eat here in the desert. Send the crowds away so they can go to the villages and buy some food. But Jesus replied, that isn't necessary. You feed them.
What?
Should we try that again? Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. What?
They exclaimed, we have exactly
5
small loaves of bread and
2
fish. Well, it'll be better. Bring them here, he said. Then he told the people to sit down on the grass. And he took the 5 loaves and the 2 fish and looked up into the sky, and he asked God's blessing on the meal. Then broke the loaves apart and gave them to the disciples to place before the people. And everyone ate until
full.
And then when the scraps were picked up afterwards, there were
12
baskets left over. About 5,000 men were in the crowd that day, besides all the women and children. It was a miracle.
Thanks, Paul. I'll just try it quicker. Thank you. You're going to have to do it long enough. Okay. So today we are thinking about giving, and I wanted to use Mr. Men to think about how we give as a people. So, are we ready? There we go. Do we give like Mr. Lace? Do we procrastinate? Do we wonder, what shall I give? I'll owe you something. Or do we give like Mr. Rush? Always like in our pocket, kind of like, oh, I've got that, so that's what I'll give. Or I'll do that because I've got 5 minutes of my time, or I'll just be there and do that. Or do we give like Mr. Tickle? Do we give time instead of something else? Do we change what we give? Do we give like Mr. Worry? Are we concerned about what we give and worry about the future? About Mr. Mean? Do we always just buy the stuff that's discounted, or buy one, get one free, or look to kind of being really grumpy about what we're doing? Do we show off and tell other people how much we give or what we do all the time? Or do we give? Do we give mathematically, working out exactly what we should give? Or do we give cheerfully, generously, and with trust? I wonder, what sort of giver are you? Would you like a chocolate?
Thank you very much.
Pleasure. Well, who knows, we'll find out, won't we? We'll see which ones are left at the end. It'll be the bounty, won't it? Anybody want the bounty? So while I am bringing these chocolates around, what sort of giver are you, and how do you give? As we think about the story of Jesus feeding the 5,000, we remember that they had nothing, that Jesus told the disciples, essentially, you can give them, and they were like, well, we can't, because we haven't got anything to give them. And we need to mend, so you're going to have to just send them home. Paul's very happy, he's a bit more fun. Do you want to
start?
You can start eating them now. Keep getting a bit.
You're right.
You've got to have them, apparently.
Here we go.
Right.
You see, what we give, whatever it is we do, whether it's like a massive thing that we give, or a little tiny moment of time, or a penny, whatever we give, we bless others through giving of our lives. And as today we think about extravagant generosity, thinking about how we give as a church and why we do that, we're going to use the story of these people listening to Jesus, being fed by him. And so we imagine this little boy coming. We're not told it's a little boy, Matthew, you have to read John's account for it to find out it's a boy. But we read this boy coming, bringing his lunch and saying, well, actually, probably two, bringing his food and saying, here, I can give this to share with others. And you can imagine the laughter of the disciples and everybody around like that. Yes, because that's going to feed 5,000 people, plus 5,000 men, plus their wives and their children and everybody else that's there. But he gave of himself and he trusted God. And this story isn't just about Jesus loving people and being caring and compassionate. It's about Jesus, the Son of God, providing for his people in a way that they couldn't provide for themselves. They hadn't got the food or the money, we're told, to go and feed all these thousands of people. And yet this little boy brings his five loaves and his two fish. And Jesus asks God to bless it. And whatever we think of the miracle, and whether it really happened the way that it's written in the Bible, or whether something else amazing happened, whatever happened, it was a miracle. All these people were fed. And not just fed a little bit with like half of a crumb. Not only did Jesus provide for them, but he provided in such a way that he left how many baskets of food left over? 12. It's like not just a little bit left over, but an abundance of leftover food. And so we are reminded about the truth of God's provision for us. Jesus provides for us in every way imaginable. So we're going to take a moment now to think about how has Jesus provided for you, whether that might be a big way or a little one, in the past few weeks or months. And you're going to tell somebody. Tell the person next to you, maybe, or the person behind you, or in front of you. But anyway, are you ready? Go. Anybody else?
how God provides for us, we're reminded to trust him. This boy took his lunch and trusted Jesus and gave all of himself. And Jesus took it and asked God to use it to bless others. You see, no matter what we give, how much we give, whether we think it's a lot or a little, God will use it to bless others with. No matter how we feel about it and how inadequate we feel, the giving of ourselves enables God to bless others as we give of ourselves. Jesus uses us, and he not in a it's a bad word, isn't it? But not in a negative way, but in a really positive way. He multiplies what we have as we give of ourselves just as we are, and multiplies that by the power of the Spirit and brings glory to him. Imagine that child's face and the story that he had to tell the next day when he'd taken his lunch to Jesus and Jesus had done an amazing miracle and fed all these people. Imagine what he said, the glory of God revealed through his gift. God is our provider. He provides for us in every area of our lives. And quite often that is in ways that we don't ever expect or imagine. Sometimes we think, you are providing for us. We need this, but actually what God does is he provides for us in the ways that we do need, in the ways that we know. He transforms us as we come to him. And today, as we think about giving extravagantly, we're thinking about it particularly because we know, as a church, we need to build a firm foundation. We're very aware, as a church, that actually over the last couple of years, we have done an amazing thing and served people in this community and provided for them, and God has used what we have brought to him and blessed others in abundance with it. We're very aware that actually people, the inflation and cost of everything and just stuff is going up. We know that. And we want to continue to care and to strive to care for others and for one another and our community and the world. And we are so thankful for all the things that God has done and blessed and the opportunities that we've had to care and to follow him and to grow. You see, what this story teaches us is that God will provide when we offer what we have. He teaches us that to grow in our faith, we will see one another grow. And we've seen so many changes during the pandemic, so many changes over the last couple of years in the lives of our families and our friends and our community here in Carrollton and beyond.
Excuse me, why is it, as I said to the surgeon last week, we take calcium every day to make our bones so strong?
Yeah.
Yet it's still great.
Because they just wear out, don't they? Our bones wear out and our hearts wear out. And God gives us the courage to keep going. And so as a church, what we're doing is saying, let's keep going. Let's keep on giving extravagantly. Let's be aware that the bills have gone up in our homes and personally our expenses have gone up. But let's be aware as well that, that our expenses here in church have gone up. Let's keep on building and keep on giving and keep on meeting one another's needs. Keep on sharing the good news with each other. Because as we do that, as we bring our five loaves and our two fish to Jesus, he provides and he blesses others. And so can we help? Can we help to bless other people through the things that we are doing here? And here's a couple of quick ways that we can help to do that. You can take a packet of Smarties home and eat the Smarties or give them to somebody else. And fill a tube with pound coins and bring it back. Dead easy, dead simple. Take it home, fill it with pound coins, because we've all got pound coins at home. Well, not so much now, because we don't have so much cash. But you get the idea. You can just pretend and do it online with a code. But anyway, so you get the idea. So take a packet of Smarties, fill it up, bring it back. Just a really simple and quick and easy way that we can help and provide for others. And enable church to pay its bills. The other way is in the backs of the chairs, there are packs like this, and in the packs of the envelopes, there's a sheet about giving, regularly giving monthly, and there's a QR code that you can use to give to some workers. As we think about giving, we don't, while we say yes, we need to pay our bills, we do need to pay our bills, but we want to give extravagantly and generously to others and bless others so they will know and see the love that God has for them as we provide for their needs. So maybe we can dig a little deeper. Maybe we can give a one-off gift. Maybe we can say commit to giving something more regularly. Maybe we can fill a tube of Smarties with pound coins. As we ask God to bless our giving, to bless others around. And so let's just be still. We're going to pause for a minute and pray. Lord, we come to you. Let our hearts be changed and renewed. We come with open arms, bringing of ourselves all that we can bring. And we trust in you to provide for all that we need. Jesus, help us to be a cheerful giver, to give extravagantly, because you gave to us. We go to Paul, and Paul teaches, talks about being joyful in giving, and he gives us the reason why. And the reason why is because Jesus gave for us. Jesus gave his whole life for us, so that we could know his love and his peace in our lives, his transformation in our lives. And so we're going to pray together. Let's pray. Dear God, you are generous to us in so many ways. Help us to become more like you. Help us this week to be more generous. Bring our whole life, my whole life, to you. Amen. Let's sing, be still, in the presence of God.
Thank you.
Help us to be still, to make ourselves available, to be filled afresh with your Spirit. Shepherd us into an encounter with you today, be it at the gym, on a walk, being with others, reading the Bible, or simply sitting in the garden. Thank you that the more of you we take in, the more we can give out. May we soak you up like sponges, taking in all that you have to give, and so inspire others to drink in and find fulfillment in you. And Father, we pray for the five people laid on our hearts during the 10 days of Thy Kingdom Come project. If we take our fingers of our hand and touch each finger individually as we name these people and pray that they will come to know you, Jesus. Let's just take a moment. Gracious Lord, we pray, Holy Spirit, come fill us afresh. Lord, forgive us for the days we don't feel like rejoicing and when we find peace invading us. We find ourselves fearing situations we can't control, doubting what we can't see or understand. Help us to believe and rejoice in your wonders so that we can live as spirit-filled children of God. Gracious Lord, we pray, Holy Spirit, come fill us afresh. We pray, Holy Spirit, for all who lack confidence, for parents struggling to meet the needs of their families, for children struggling with their work at school, for teachers struggling to meet the demands of the day, for young people who feel misunderstood, for young adults struggling to find their place in the world, for carers trying to support and comfort those who are vulnerable, for the frail facing diminishing strength and loss of identity, for all people struggling to be who they truly are. Gracious Lord, we pray, Holy Spirit, come fill us afresh. And Saint Ignatius wrote a prayer, Lord Jesus, teach me to be generous. Teach me to serve as you deserve, to give and not to count cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to labour and not to seek rest, to give of myself and not to ask for a reward, except the reward of knowing that I am doing your will. And finally, Father, help us to acknowledge and be thankful for all the gifts and talents you bestow on us. With the help of your Spirit, show us how to use these gifts for the benefit of your kingdom. Gracious Lord, we pray. Holy Spirit, come fill us afresh. Amen.
And so let's pray together. Generous God, may your Spirit continue to transform our lives and this church. Holy Spirit, would you guide us as we strive together to follow Jesus? Help us as we strive together to care for one another, our community and the world. Teach us as we strive together to grow in our faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And as Jesus taught us, we draw our prayers to a close with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. So as part of our worship, we're going to take up our offering. So if you would like to give to our ministry, then this is an offering. opportunity for us to give. So if you, the pot will come round, there's also the QR code that you can use for that on your phone.
Thank you.
fill us with every blessing, that we may share in every good work, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. So this week, go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. A great week. I'll see you next week.
Don't get smart.